Dear students, welcome you all to the course that is Circular Knitting Technology. So, in the last sessions, we have discussed about the main components in double weight circular knitting machines and what are the technological evolutions are taken place and what are the points to be considered to get higher productivity and the good quality. So, this session particularly we are going to discuss about the selection systems. Okay, so how the selection systems and what are the different types of selection systems are there and how it can be going to operate to get different fabric structures, the complicated structures. For example, if you want any striped pattern, irregular stripes in the knitted fabric itself. So, if you would like to use yarn dyed or yarn dyed yarns into the knitted fabric production to produce irregular stripes or any design or any fabric structures, and what are the different type of selection systems are required to get particular construction or particular fabric structures. Okay, so this particular section we are going to discuss about selection systems in the circular knitting technology. So, we'll see here what are the different types of selection systems are. So, selection of the needles is very, very important to get the fabric structure. So, which needle has to be raised up and what is the position of rising up or lowering down or the loop formation, when the loop formation is happening. Okay, so that is why to form like a basic kind of stitches, you know that the knit stitch, tuck stitch and mid kind of stitches. So to get different stitches, you are going to vary the movement of the needle. So that is the clearing positions of the needle you are going to vary. So depends upon the movement of rising and lowering down, you are going to get the different kind of stitches in the knitted fabric. Now, to get different structures, like there are knitted fabric structures as you already studied, okay, like the PQs, single PQs, Pinto, Dirama. So, there are different fabric structures you have. So, to produce that, what are the selection, how and how we can get the particular type of fabric structure. So, what are the selection can be taken place in the needle. So, we will see particularly in this particular section. So, now the first selection system, that is selection by means of needles with the multiple butts. So, there are multi-cam track systems in the knitting technology and as well as multi-level butt systems also we have. Okay, so by using these, how we can select the needles, we will see that one by one. So this is the first one, and there is a second one, that is jacquard selection. There is a jacquard selection to produce different or complicated fabric structures in the knitted fabric. So, complicated fabric designs or fabric structures, to produce the complicated designs, it is very important to go further, or by using the jacquard systems, it can be achieved. So, jacquard selection is generally classified into two categories. One is called as a mechanical jacquard selection system and the second one is called as an electronic jacquard selection system. So, these are the three basic things we are going to study in the particular session. So these are the three different types of selection systems we are using in the circular knitting technology to produce the different or varieties of complicated designs in the fabric structure. So now we will see in this particular session, we will see that the first one, that is selection by means of needles with multi-level butts. So, in general, The patterns are produced in weft-knitted structures either in the form of selected colors or face stitches or surface relief patterns, okay, based on a choice of different types of stitches. So as I told, there are basically like three different type of stitches, that is called as like knit stitch, tuck stitch and the misstitch. So by using different varieties of stitches and by changing the color of your weft thread or the thread, so you can get the different patterns in the weft knitted structure. So that is in general. So now the width of the pattern in whales is determined by how many needles can be selected separately, independently each other. So how many number of colors or how many number of needles we are using into the particular section is very important. And the pattern depth in courses is depend upon the number of feeds with the selection facility. Okay. And the cam arrangements and element but, the cam arrangement and element but repeat set out will determine the patterns. Okay. Will determine the patterns. Nothing but the cam arrangements and the element but, the butt of the needle is very important to get the desired pattern. Now, popular simple method employ different butt lengths and cam thicknesses. So, this case specifically, we are going to look out different butt lengths and cam thicknesses we are varying. Okay, different cam thicknesses, okay, and our different butt positions and cam tracks we are using. So, multiple cam tracks. First thing, butt lengths we are varying, cam thicknesses, cam track thicknesses we are varying. So to get different structures, we are varying this many parameters in the knitting zone. So in the knitting zone, we have basically like a main important things to form the fabric structures are, one is cam. So cam arrangements and the needle butts are very important to form the fabric structure. So what is our variations or what we are varying to get the different fabric structures are, one is butt lengths we are varying, cam thicknesses we are varying, and different butt positions we are varying. So nothing but, so this is the needle and here is the butt, and this is one case, and second one here is the butt, third one here is the butt. So long butt, short butt or medium butt. So the butt positions on the stem of the needle is going to be varied. So by varying all these parameters, we are going to get different fabric structures in the knitted fabric. Okay. So now you can see that one of the example, different length of butts. Different lengths of butts. You can observe that there are three needles which are shown in the image. 1, 2, 3. And you can observe that the needle 1 is having a very long butt. So the butt position, the butt of the needle, say for example, this is the needle and this is the butt. So now the butt length is very lengthy in the first case. So that is long butt. So longer butt. And you can see that the second needle type, which is having medium butt. And the third one is short butt. So different butt lengths of the butt we are varying, but butt position is same, the position of the butt is same, but what is the difference is, the difference is butt length is different, butt butt length is different. So long butts, medium butt and short butt we are using to get knit type of stitch, tuck type of stitch and miss type of stitch. Okay, so you can see that the clearing cam is going to follow the, nothing but the clearing cam path is going to followed by the long butt needle, and tuck position is going to be followed by the medium butt needle, and the up through cam path is going to be followed by the short butt needle. So which is shown in the image, you can clearly observe that the butts and how these are going to be followed in the particular cam paths are. Okay, so now you can see that what are the butt positions, high butt and low butt I told. So butt thickness or butt length, you can observe that high butt nothing but butt length is more, low butt nothing but butt length is very smaller. Now you can see that number of butts also we have varied. So needles with both high and low butts. So needles are having some of the needles or the specific requirement. As per the requirement, we are going to produce or we are going to use the needles with both high and low butts. Both high and low butts. So you can see that high butt as well as the low butt needles are commonly we are using in the case number, say for example 1, 2, 3, 4 and the last one is having the multi-level butts, that is high butt as well as the low butt in the same needle. Okay, so in the same needle, so whenever, see for example, if this is the case, so low butt as well as the high butt it is there. So now whenever the clearing part is came, high butt is going to follow the path and as well as the low butt also going to follow the same cam track. So now this type of needles are going to be used for multiple cam track systems, multi cam track systems. So in multi cam tracks, nothing but cam track 1 we have seen and cam track 2 also will be there, cam track 3 also will be there. So cam track 1, cam track 2, cam track 3. So particular cam tracks, these particular needle butts are going to be followed. Okay, so that whenever there is a knit, the needle is going to be form the knit stitch. Whenever the tuck cams are there, that position tuck kind of stitches are going to be followed in the fabric. So you can observe that here I have given three different type of needle butts, high butt, medium butt and low butt needles. And as you can observe that the clearing positions and the path of the needles, you can observe that in the loop of the previous feeder and the loops of the needle at the clearing height, you can observe that high butt needles are going to be cleared fully and low butt or medium butt, you can observe that for medium butt needles are going to form the tuck stitch and the medium to the low butt. So in the third one, that is low butt needles are going to be formed this kind of stitches, nothing but high butt knit stitch, low butt tuck stitch, low nothing but medium butt is forming the tuck stitch, low butt, completely low butt is going to form the this kind of stitch. So by varying this butt thickness, we are going to produce the different knit stitches or stitches in the fabric. So we'll see here how these multi cam track systems are going to be used and worked in the double jersey knitting machines are. So where you can observe that, so the bottom cam tracks are called as the cylinder cam tracks. You can observe that there is a cylinder cam system and the top one cam systems are called as the dial cam systems. So cylinder and the dial cam systems. Now you can see here particularly, for example, you can see here the long butt, okay, long butt needle which is having the long butt. So the butt position in the needle is different. So long butt needle is going to be used for the bottom side of the particular cam track. So nothing but cam track 1, cam track 2 for example. So cam track 1 is going to be followed by short butt needles. Butt position in the needle stem, butt position in the needle stem you need to observe. So you need to observe that the butt position on the needle stem. So if the butt position on the needle stem is long, nothing but the needle is long needle. So the particular long needle is going to be followed in the cam track of cylinder 1. Now the short needle is going to be followed in the cam track 2 of cylinder. Similarly, in case of dial system also, we are using long needles as well as the short needles. Okay. So particularly like interlock fabric structures as we have discussed. So long needles and the short needles we are using. So long needles are going to follow in particular one path of the cam, and short needles are going to be followed in the one particular cam track. So there are two cam tracks. So long needles and short needles, if we are using, long needles are going to be followed in one particular cam track, and the short needles are going to be followed in the one particular cam track. So I think it is followed, or you people are following. You again see here, cam track, so two different cam tracks available. One cam track for the long needles and the second cam track is for the short needles. Okay. So particularly the long needles are going to follow at one particular path of the cam track, and the small needle, okay, short needles are going to follow in the particular cam track. So which is shown here. So depends upon the cam types we are using, we are going to produce whether it is knitting or whether it is up throughs. So you can see that the first case, that is long needle, is having the clearing position, and the short needle is having in the particular place running up through, just it is going. Okay, so there is no formation of stitch in the particular area. So that is how the needle are going to work in the multi-cam track systems. Okay. So to get interlock fabric structure, this is the way we need to arrange the cams and the needles in the system. Okay. So you can see here. So cylinder cam systems are there and dial cam systems are there, and long needle is going to follow in the particular cam track, and short needle is going to follow in the particular cam track of cylinder. So these two are cylinder needles, and now the long needle of dial, short needle of dial is going to follow separate cam tracks. Okay, so that is how we are going to produce the interlock fabric structures. Now you can see here the needles with both high and low buds are shown here, and you can see that the multi cam track system and the needles, you can observe that long needle, medium needle, short needle, long needle, medium needle and short needle. So three cam tracks are there. You can observe that three long bud or long needle is following just up through. Second medium is tucked. Third one, that is following the knit. So from the cam side, you can observe that from the cam side, I am telling, from the cam side, first needle, that is short needle, is going to produce the knit, because the cam type which we have used is clearing cam. And the second one, that is medium needle, is going to follow the second cam track. Okay. And it is shown that the tuck kind of stitch is going to form. And the third needle is just going up through the cam, up through cam, mistitch is going to formed. So if you want to produce different kind of structures, we are going to use different kind of cams in the knitting machine. Okay. So you can see here a particular design, one of the example I have given here, to produce the fabric structure of like what I have shown in the below. You can see that the cross mark indicates, what is the notation? The cross mark is indicates that is a knit. Dot indicates tuck, and blank box indicates that is miss. So notations I am giving again. Okay, hence you know, hence already you have studied, cross mark indicates that is knit, dot indicates in the box is called as tuck, empty box is called as the miss stitch. Okay, so you can observe that the structure of the fabric, you can see that how the cams are arranged in the cam system, you can see that. So now A, you can observe that A, course 1, A and course 1, you can observe that first cross mark, okay, then miss, then tuck, then cross mark. A, B, C, D, you need to go for in the cam track systems, A, B, C, D like that. And while reading in the whales, you need to see that in the horizontal manner, A, B, C, D. Okay, so you need to see that, you need to follow the graphical representation or notational diagram which I have shown for particular fabric structure. So you can see that the cross mark, so first is cross mark, miss, then tuck, then knit. Okay, so like that, the second course, knit, knit, miss, tuck. Third, tuck, knit, knit, miss. So this is how we are going to prepare the cam system in the knitting machine. So first, what we are doing, what is the procedure of preparing the cam system is, preparing the cam system, first we need to identify, or first we need to analyze the fabric structure, what is the kind of fabric structure is, or if you have created any new structure, you need to plot the notational diagrams in the graph, and then this graph you are going to use to set up the cam arrangements in the knitting machine. Okay, so this is how you are going to arrange the needles or arrange the cams in the knitting machine for getting the particular structure of the fabric. Now you can see here, by this image you can know that how many number of cam tracks should be required. So you can say that 4 cam tracks are required to produce a particular design. Okay, so you can see that the track 1, track 2, track 3, track 4. So 4 cam tracks are required. So in this case, again you need to select the needles. 4 levels of needle butts are required: long, medium 1, medium 2, short. Long, medium 1, medium 2 and short. So 4 different levels of butts is required to get this kind of structure. Okay, so generally in the knitting industries, this kind of structures are going to be used, and this kind of needle types are going to be used to get more production and more design. Complicated designs also we can produce by using this multi-level or multi-cam track systems. Okay, this is how we are going to produce the fabric structures. Okay, so this session particularly we have discussed how and what are the different types of needles and cam tracks are used in for getting the different fabric structures in the knitting machine. Okay, so I think you people understand. Okay, so we will discuss in the next session, that is jacquard selection. So particularly this session we have seen that selection systems, what are the different type of selection systems are there, and specifically we have talked about the selection system, particularly multi cam tracks and multi-level butts. If you use these kind of multi-level butts and multi-cam tracks, how we can produce the fabric structures, we have learned from this session. And for the next session, we will discuss about the jacquard selection mechanisms, and that too, the mechanical jacquard and the electronic jacquards selection systems in the knitting machine. So till then, thanks for listening. Bye.